Is she waiting? Open the gate.
No, it's dangerous. It's dangerous. Don't open the gate. Don't.
She's done it.
So dark. It's dark. The darkness.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the dead may cross into hell.
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. They came through stormy black seas. They raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. These gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender. Abandon to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye. And you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left. Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess. Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize. Half black, and half the color of flesh. And her face, menacing and grim.
source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior, you're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Hell is reaching deep inside of her. Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You fail the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there is no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere you failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your sword.
Come on. There.
Why go on, when you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined? Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. Song.
It's not real. It's a trick. It's not real. It's real. Listen to it.
She don't give up.
Did it?
It's not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in yourself?
It's real. It's happening. Go towards it. He's gone and you were too slow. How could you keep going? How could you keep going? Ignore the pain. I told you it was to trick you.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbal, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. Was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
Everything's gone. It's already disappeared. Nothing lives here, not even you. It's in your mind. You think you can see it, but it's in your mind.
There he was. She remembers the first time she saw him. To her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. For the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Signal. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. And then he draws Signal's touch. And his brother.
Watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance. Wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
It's a trick. It's an illusion. It's not real. But you really want it's real. You want to believe it's real, but it's a trick. You're deluded. Where are you going? Where is she going? What is she following? You can't even follow. It's just deception.
How does he so effortlessly court the world and bliss? If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You... learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans evil. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
Take a sword.
A sword?
Take it.
Dillian left it for you.
Take it.
Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gram by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands, where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go
go to the shards.
What's the shard? Find it.
It's the metal runestones. Where is it?
Find it. There it is.
Focus.
Where's the shard? Focus.
Focus.
Use your eyes. Look.
Get closer.
What can you see? Go to it.
It's not safe.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world. Fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, and sick.
She can't. Open the gate.
It's locked. Try harder.
She can't.
She will.
She'll find a way. She finds a way.
Through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Where is he?
Where's he gone? We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senua explored new paths into the unknown.
Senua. You've got it.
Why isn't he here?
He's gone.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the Dark World.
You're in the wrong world.
He's in the other world.
The Dark World.
Without you.
You have no chance.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend.
Dillian undoes the
Dillian.
Does it feel like to feel enough?
She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go. And she was caught between two worlds. That of Zimbel and her past. And Dillian. Her future.
They mean nothing.
Two realities. Tearing at her soul.
Could all be a waste of her time.
Do you remember the gods are just talking? What if the gods are laughing at her?
Messing with her.
It wouldn't be good.
Time.
Feast and rejoice, and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do.
You feel.
nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
Lying.
If you think it makes sense, but really the gods are playing with you.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense in the real
world.
The gods are playing, but it doesn't mean anything.
You can't read this language, you don't understand.
Sinbel was right.
You're wasting time.
You're cursed.
You'll never succeed.
Slow! Quicker!
Dillian never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Sinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, and to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Careful.
Don't look down.
Breathe.
No!
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have?
But there's more. There's more.
The gift makes you so special in life.
There's still more.
There's always more.
Just
it's not going to be easy.
You're getting tired. Can you do another one? It's too much.
I'm left for the world to protect you from
the energy.
No.
Too much to do.
Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels... What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong.
This place stinks.
Oh, it's disgusting.
It smells like...
Ugh. I can't breathe.
There he is. The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in. He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Keep going. How do you find it?
It's just a test. It's a test. Like the old warrior trials.
Lillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? Don't worry, not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. To the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong, something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
The bridge. It's broken. Fix it.
You have to fix it. Now you have to find him.
Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
Thank you.
come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there?
Find him. You have to find him.
It's too loud. It's too loud. Stop.
Delia! They're coming for me!
Focus. Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. That doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
Do with the sword.
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless guess.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just that.
their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
A king in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn. And it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
The daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
Dillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
There he is. Dillian,
there he is. Finally.
You found him. What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me?
How did you let him go?
Just wait there. I'll find you.
Find him, get him back.
He was just there. How could you lose him? How could she lose
him? How could she? Find him.
I'll find him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist.
I can hear him.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword,
She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
Find another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find a...
Think. Focus.
It's not here.
We told you. We told you it was a trick.
Hervor ignores her father's warnings. The grave mound opens, and it seems to be full of fire. Again, Hervor demands her inheritance, but her father warns her that the sword is cursed and would be the bane of her family. But he relents and brings her the sword. She leaves the island with it, but the curse holds true, and death would follow in the years to come. And so... Senua, the misdeeds of a father who cursed his daughter.
Look for clues.
What is it?
What's different?
There's a clue.
It's not Dillian. wants me to face my fears. Father? I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief and son.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you.
No.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Were yours, but they're the gods now.